This work is inside another much bigger project, and I am going to show you just the specific part about design using design patterns. This is the outline of the presentation. First, I will introduce you to the world of haptic simulation. After that, I will show the objectives and the main part of this work, which is the framework we have designed. I will finish with some conclusions. If you don't know about haptic devices, this is our haptic device, it's the one we are using. The haptic devices are an input and output devices that are used for integrating the sense of touch inside applications. So we have a lab with 12 working places for students to try specifically in learning simulators for surgery in the vet faculty of the University of León. The problem with surgery is that although there are a lot of simulators, in many cases they are dedicated simulators. You have in here some examples. And as you can see, this is dedicated hardware. They cost a lot of money. And some specific departments of big hospitals can afford them. But at university, it's impossible for us. And besides that, we want our students, well, not our students, because I belong to computer science, but students from PEC, they want their students to try several different surgery procedures, so they cannot afford them, but they wouldn't be any case interested in something like this that is only useful for practicing surgery of the eye. They don't need any kind of surgery. So our proposal is a more general environment. This is the one we are using. We have a workstation and two haptic devices for any of the simulators we will develop in the future. What our students need is to have a lot of practice with their hands. So haptic devices is the perfect tool for them. The problem they have if we do not provide this kind of environment is work with dead bodies or with mannequins that do not always show the diseases that they want to practice on. So this can be a very good solution. So we need a model for building this haptic simulator for surgery. And we want them to be tools for learning. So we don't want just the students to practice in a very realistic domain. That's not our goal. Our goal is that they can use these simulators as e-learning tools. So our model describes a learning teaching process so that an expert can define what he wants their students to learn. I'm talking about specific techniques for each surgery procedure. And the student can play, we say play, because we think this can be thought of as serious games. The student plays with the simulator and then gets a lot of practice. Our model will be used for producing haptic simulators for surgery because we hope to need lots of them and we want to develop them in a shorter period of time. That's why we are developing a general framework to speed up that process. So the main part of our model is what we call a learning unit. You will tell me if that is really a learning unit. This is how I will try to explain to you what a learning unit is for us with a specific example. The specific example is about our first simulator we are developing, which is the cataract surgery simulator. So we have in the first part the expert who knows how to perform a surgery, in this case a cataract surgery. The expert has all the knowledge, all the experience, and that experience has to be transmitted to their students. So what we do in the middle is to place the teaching part, our unit, our learning unit, where we include all the experience of the expert. So we divide the simulator in several steps, which are the parts that the students have to follow to perform the surgery, so that in each step the expert decides what has to be done and how it has to be done and how that has to be graded for the student to get a final result. We want this unit not only to grade the student, but also to tell the student how has been his performance, with comments on his actions. So our starting point is that the model has already been defined. We want that learning unit in the middle. Our program domain is surgery, and we propose as a solution haptic simulators. So inside that predefined state, we want to establish the design of that framework that will allow us to build simulators more quickly. We will be using, of course, design patterns for trying to get it in less time. And this is the part I am going to show you. This is a BPMN diagram for you to see more or less how this is working, how is the process. We have in here our lecturer, our expert, that transferred his experience to this part of the simulator, of the surgery system, we have called the check step. Okay? So the experience of the expert is in here. I'll tell you later what else happens. And the lecturer also gets some outcome about what the user has done in each working session with the simulator. We have in here the student that will show the will select the simulator. We want to have some of them and then start the simulation. As I already said, in each simulator we have several steps. This is just one step and it's repeated. Inside each step we have several actions that the user can go through, and when the step is finished, then the main part is the check step, where the step is checked depending on what the expert has said about that step. And after that, the expert has some information, the student gets some information, some feedback, and then the grade is composed. So how do we design that that framework? We are using design patterns, and you can check the class diagram in the paper. In here I have chosen these kind of pictures. I think are more easy to see. So we have in here the steps. We divide each surgery procedure into, and inside each of these steps we have the state machine pattern that I will show you later. And then when we change from one step to another one, then the grade obtained from that step is stored, and then the final score is calculated. So what happens inside each one of these states it's the state machine. The state machine has several states, and to change from one state to another one, a different surgery tool is chosen. As you can see in here, the arrows that go to a wrong state are go and forth, because if some wrong tool is chosen, that is just informed to the user, and then he returns to the previous state. When the stick machine enters one state, then a visitor pattern begins to work, so that it visits each element of the anatomy and places in each part of the anatomy a specific observer for that step. Sorry, for that state. Okay? Because, for instance, if I am in this step, which is the capsulorhesis, which is to remove the anterior capsule, and I am the observer of the anterior capsule, I have to make sure that it has been removed. But in this state, if I am the observer of the lens, I have to make sure that the lens have not been touched. So depending on the states, these observers are specific. So what do we get this way? When we get from the point of view of the software development, we find that the design of each simulator is already defined, so we do not have to rethink it each time. We will be able to share components, because when we implement all these simulators, if I have to cut something, I can reuse that behavior for cutting something else. Okay? If I learn how to cut the anterior lens, I will know how to cut any other part of the body. Depending on the material used, there will be some changes, but there are a big part that I can reuse. From the expertise info point of view, we have structured the information that we have to get from the experts. So when we interview the surgeons, we want them to tell us, to explain us the surgery procedures in terms of states, steps, actions, etc. And it's more easier and more quick. This way, because the input, the requirements of my system are settled, we can go directly from the requirements phase to the implementation phase, because the design is already so we get shorter development time for producing new simulators. What do we have in the near future? We are all the day chasing surgeons, because it's very difficult to get hours of the expert, like always happens. And we are developing our first haptic simulator, which is a cataract surgery simulator. For doing that, we are using a game engine called Auger, and in order to integrate haptics with our final development, we are implementing what we have called H-Auger, which is the version of Auger that integrates the haptic devices. By now, that's fine. Thank you.